I won't use it either way, just so we have a backup.
So here we are. That's Jack. This is Michael. I was in charge of recording the wedding ceremony. It's a big deal. I'm just testing everything out right now to make sure
I got it done. Hit.
Yeah, the llamas, people are going to be riding those by the end of the night for sure. I already fed all three of them.
Yeah, this says no feeding.
That one, oh wow, this camera is touchy. That one right there, that's my favorite. Yeah, so
it's a beautiful place. Wait, it's not on you. There you go.
We're just here to just practicing out my skills on the camera. Here's a ladybug on the steering wheel.
I gotta check my fantasy team.
See that ladybug? Okay. All right, don't want to waste battery. Over and out.
Let these things be off. Off.
Please rise. Yeah.
friends and family, we welcome you here today to witness this rededication of a marriage. Now, some of you were there at the first one, and by witnessing this today, they ask all of you to share in their future. A marriage is a promise made in the hearts of two people who love each other, and it takes a lifetime to fulfill. Within the circle of marriage, it encompasses all of life's most important relationships. A wife and a husband are each other's lovers, teachers, listeners, critics, and best friends. And it is into this state that you two risk to rededicate each other. So. Tyler, do you recommit yourself to Crystal? We love, honor, and cherish her in all times, in good and bad. And do you promise to continue to stay in love with her as long as you both shall live? You also recommit yourself to Tyler. Do you love, honor, and cherish him in good times and in bad? Do you promise to continue to stay true to him as long as you both shall live? Now you just pledged to be each other's loving friends and partners in a marriage. To talk and listen, to trust and appreciate one another, to respect and cherish each other's uniqueness, support, comfort, and strengthen each other through each other's life sorrows and joys. May you promise to share all your hopes and thoughts and dreams as you build your lives together. May your lives be ever intertwined, your love keeping you together. May you build a home that is compassionate to all, full of respect and honor for others and each other. And may it be ever filled with peace, happiness, and love. Now, a modern prophet once wrote, by the way, his name's Marley, it's not perfect, but you aren't either. The two of you will never be perfect. But if he can make you laugh at least once, causes you to think twice, and if he admits to being human and making mistakes, hold on to him and give him the most you got. He's not going to quote poetry. He's not going to think about you every moment. But he will give you a part of him that he knows you could bring. Don't hurt him. Don't change him. And don't expect more than he can give. Don't analyze. Smile when he makes you happy. Yell when he makes you mad. And miss him when he's not there. Love is hard when there is love to be had. Because perfect guys don't exist, but there's always one guy who's perfect for you. Now, they're already wearing their rings. Show your rings off. Rings are a symbol of unity, in which you've already joined in an unbroken circle, and I'm sure by now you've had a few experiences of what that means. But know that, just like your rings are endless, you can always come back to each other. All right. May your home be a haven of peace, and your relationship be one of truth and understanding. May you enjoy the length of days, fulfillment of hopes, and peace and contentment of mind as you, day by day, fulfill and live the terms of the covenant that you have reestablished here today. Not as much as you have repeated your commitment to another, I rededicate you as husband and wife. Remember this part from yesterday? All right, remember 5 to 7. You may kiss each other. Music? All right, then head on out.
Thank you all for coming. And I really appreciate all our family and friends that are able to make it. That's all I got.
You're good.
Okay, thanks everybody for coming as well, and father of the bride. It's my first one of these, so this might be a little long, so bear with me. Julie did encourage me to cut out the 20-slide PowerPoint presentation and not use any props, so maybe it'll go faster. Quick remembrance for Crystal's grandparents, Julie's parents, Harold and Rosemary, who couldn't be here today, so they would all be here, I'm sure. A big thanks to Crystal's other grandparents, my parents, Phil and Barb, down there. Thanks for everything you guys have done in my life for me and our kids. Dad, for all the experiences that you've shared with our kids, and Mom, for things like the Christmas fashion show that you put on, all the presents we got from the cold and stuff. Another special mention to my sister, Chris, Auntie Chris to the kids. Whenever the kids' schedule was really full, she was always there, and really appreciate it. Julie, love my mom, bye. We're doing good. Wish I had a prop so I could put it in front of my face. Love the crying. Crystal, we couldn't be prouder of you. From the little girl who could read. Bedtime stories. Bad. To you being a monster, what greater than you are now. Through all the hard work that you did fighting, through injuries, trying to play soccer. Surprised you made it through the wedding from getting hurt. We'll see about the honeymoon though. To meeting and marrying Tyler. Our first knowledge of Tyler was hearing that Crystal and him were seeing each other in high school. Shortly after, we heard how they met. Have you guys heard this story? Late at night, Crystal snuck out and met him late at night from a girls' party. So Julie and I had to go and scout around and find out about this kid and see what he was all about, what he was like. And, turned out all right. Concerning to learn that your daughter wasn't a perfect angel anymore. Just a regular angel. But thanks to the families that indulged us and helped you were to never say that was you guys ever. Part of our sources, appreciate it. It was fun watching Tyler and all his activities. Better day that winning pitcher on the Capco tournament thing, very good. But it's been fun, and congrats to Will and Aaron for Tyler Carroll being such a great kid. It's been great watching Tyler and Crystal grow together while you'll always be my little girl. I'm so happy you found a great man, Tyler. Hopefully you and Tyler will have the same happiness then. My advice for fulfilling lives together is pursue your life to ensure that you have individual happiness. Work together to help each other achieve your happiness. And when you're ready, give up yourself to ensure your whole family is happy. Thank you.
I've never done one of these either before, so we're gonna see how this goes. Thank you everyone for coming and supporting Crystal and Tyler in this great day of both of their lives. I just want to say you've got no idea how much I've been looking forward to today. After all, I've been friends with Tyler. He has long at last admitted that I am the best man. I want to start off by saying thank you for everyone who has came out here to support them, and also everybody who has put together this beautiful ceremony together for these two. Tyler, it's an honor that I was chosen to stand by you today. You've always been someone that I count on for anything, and I'm just beyond grateful that I get to share this moment with you and Crystal. Tyler and I go back a few years, for those of you who don't know me. We first met at college, and we were friends right away. It may seem like it only happened a few years ago, but at this point, it seemed like I've known you my whole life. You're honestly a brother to me. Only thing keeping us away from it is blood. Tyler, you've always been my right-hand man throughout my whole life and the biggest moments of my life, and I hope that goes the same for you. And I can't wait to be able to watch everything beautiful unfold for the two of you. Let's toast to the best decision Tyler's ever made, and I wish you both a lifetime of love, happiness, and success. To Tyler and Crystal.
We're gonna keep it up, and I haven't done this before either. So, this is mine, just ditto, alright? Just kidding. Like my dad said, Crystal and Tyler didn't meet in the best of circumstances. And so, when I heard how they met, no offense, Tyler, but I wasn't exactly the most opening. Just, you know, I'm protective of my younger sister, and she's my best friend. Sorry, Mom. And so, you know, it was hard for me to open up, but I've seen how Tyler and Crystal grow up from fighting all the time to still fighting, but a little less often. And just, Tyler's grown up a lot over the years, and I am very proud to call him my brother-in-law. Hopefully we kind of take away the in-law part and become brother and sister later. And, you know, you guys are growing stronger together. And with you joining the Marines, Tyler, Crystal followed you over there. It's still a little, you know, raw. But you guys are very good together, and I'm so happy for both of you. And my advice to both of you is, no matter how hard it gets, don't go to bed alone. You know, you don't have to be next to each other. Bear and Gunner can be in the middle. But just don't go to bed. You go to bed angry, even. Just don't go to bed alone. You know, you guys are in this together. You don't have to make up, but when you wake up in the middle of the night, regretting that last comment, or if you're still angry, you can always just reach over and grab them. I'm really sorry, Tyler, for the rest of your life you're going to have Crystal punching and kicking you in the middle of sleep. But I can tell you guys will be together for the rest of your lives. And I am so happy to welcome the rest of Tyler's family into office. So congratulations, you two, and you guys will have the rest of your lives together.
I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And one always goes to you.
This is a
Yeah.